Hello folks, in this video we learn about subsets and supersets. Take a look at these two sets. A has elements 1, 2 and 3 and B has 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Clearly, every element that belongs to A also belongs to B. This is just an example, but whenever there are any two sets, say sets A and B, such that every element of set A is also an element of set B, then A is called a subset of B. In other words, whenever there are two sets, A and B, such that there is not a single element in A, which is not there in B, then set A is a subset of set B. And this is how we write A is a subset of B. The symbol looks similar to a less than or equal to symbol. And this might actually help you visualize and remember the concept of a subset. Because being a subset of another set is analogous to being less than or equal to the other set. Not the same thing, but similar. Now look at these two sets. They are, in essence, the same set. We just refer to them with different names. Now clearly, by definition, A is a subset of B because every element of A is found in B too. And for the same reason, B is also a subset of A. What I want you to understand is that every set is a subset of itself. Now look at these two sets. A is an empty set, and B is any random set. There is no element in A that is not in B. So technically, A is a subset of B. And so, you should understand and remember that an empty set is a subset of every set. Okay, let us move ahead and try listing all the subsets of this set A. The elements A has are 7, 8, and 10. Now, for a set to be a subset of A, it must not contain any element that is not in A. So, while building subsets of A, we have elements 7, 8, and 10 to choose from. Whenever you are asked to list the subsets of any set, the method generally recommended is to start from the smallest subset and subsequently move to the largest. So, the first subset that you should list is the empty set. And this would be common for all the sets because we've already seen that empty set is a subset of each and every set. Next, we list the subsets with only one element. Here they are. Moving ahead, we have the subsets with two elements. And then finally, we get to the largest possible subset in this case, the subset with three elements, which would be the set A itself. So, if you follow this method, you'll start with the null set and end with the original set itself. Also, you can see that the list contains 8 subsets. In general, if a set has n elements, the total number of possible subsets it has is 2 raised to the power n. Here, set A has 3 elements, and so the number of subsets of A is equal to 2 to the power 3, which is equal to 8. Now, something else you should know. All the subsets of any set, other than the set itself, are known as proper subsets of that set. You can see the notation for proper subsets in bold. So here, all the subsets on the list except the last one, that is the set A itself, are proper subsets of A. Alright, now a related concept is the concept of supersets. Supersets are just the opposite of subsets. It's like the parent-child relationship. If A is the child of B, then B is the parent of A. Similarly, if A is the subset of B, B is a superset of A. Simple as that. And here is how we would symbolically write B is a superset of A. That was all about subsets and supersets. The next video covers power sets. Thank you for watching.